switch case statement. Now the switch construct is a multi-way branch statement. Multi-way in the sense you can test several options at one particular time within one construct itself. When a choice is to be made from a number of options, the switch statement is useful. It requires only one argument. Remember here we don't need a condition. Even if there is just a single variable, using that itself a decision can be made. So that is another advantage of the switch statement. And this evaluates expressions and looks for value among what is called case constant. So every switch expression can have a minimum of one variable or it can have an expression. So based on the result of that expression, the switch construct will compare the values with what are called case constants. Now from the syntax, you will be able to understand this better. If the value, that is the result of the expression or the switch variable, matches with the case constant, then the particular set of case statements are executed. If not, you should have a default set of case statements which are executed if none of the conditions satisfies to true. So always remember that in the control statements, there should always be a case where we should have a set of statements which are to be executed if the conditions don't satisfy to true. So this is the syntax: switch variable expression. This is what is called the case constant. So that A is matched with the variable or the expression. The B is matched with the variable or the expression. Whichever constant matches with the variable or expression, that particular set of statements are executed. During one execution, only one of the case constant can match with the variable. If you have to execute two or more number of times, then you have to either ask for the user's choice again and again or recompile the program for you to execute another set of statements. So during one iteration or during one execution, only one case constant can match with the variable or expression. And the case constants, if you see, they are terminated with a colon. That particular statement is terminated with a colon. Then you have the set of statements, and in every case constant statement, if you see, you have a break statement. We will be seeing what is a break statement in the next slide. So this is the common syntax. Switch is a keyword. It should be in the lowercase letters. Variable and expression, there should be no semicolon at the end of the switch expression, and there should be an opening and closing brace for the switch construct. Case is also a keyword, and that case constant statement should be terminated with a colon. Now these are the parts of a switch case. We have the switch expression. It can be character or integer. We know the integers and characters available in C, that is from 1 to 3 and all the letters from A to Z, and they should not be terminated by semicolon or any other symbol. Next we have the switch execution block. When one case is satisfied, the particular set of statements are executed. Then this is a switch organization. These are the rules I have already mentioned before. The entire case structure should be enclosed within curly braces. Keyword case must be followed by a constant, only then you can have a match. Every constant should terminate with a colon. Each case constant must contain different values. You cannot have the same constant for two or three set of statements. And any number of case statements can be provided, so any number of options can be checked. A case structure which contains multiple statements need not be enclosed within braces. That is, in this case, a case structure in the sense every case constant, though it has number of statements, you don't need the braces there, like for an if or else, because you are giving the break statement and the case keyword, automatically the compiler will understand that all the statements in between the case constant and the break belong to a particular case. So when it sees the break statement itself, it will know that that particular case has ended. So that is another advantage over here. You don't need to include a lot of braces. So all these are the advantages of the switch case construct.